For the price of Dragon's Dogma 2, you can get a Mio Mini Plus and 240 ounces of malt liquor. And I'll guarantee you'll have a better time. Even if half the GBA games on there are horrible, it's better than killing the same wolves 20 times over. Dragon's Dogma 2 is a game that can't compete against its predecessor, let alone games made in 1997. But which game am I talking about? Castlevania Symphony of the Night. And I'm using Dragon's Dogma 2 as a comparison because Castlevania Symphony of the Night has more loot and more monsters than this game that just came out. And Castlevania is one of those games that also greatly benefits from being run on an emulator like the Mio. The only common complaint is its long runbacks. Complaint that literally doesn't exist with the use of save states. See, the game actually starts very, very slow. I mean, your character is very slow. Sure, you get a little abilities at the beginning, but then you're stuck with this tub of lard. You gotta push through the first few hours of this game and really beat that first boss before the castle opens up to you, and Alucard gets enough speed to actually move. The game itself looks amazing on Mio's screen. You'll really appreciate how every monster has a different and unique sprite, and then how those sprites are mixed with 3D background imagery, or 3D particle effects, to create a game whose look really stands the test of time. It's also wild to play through this game without a guide, because I'm pretty sure you don't need half the stuff you pick up. Like, getting this little devil guy felt good, because it made my character not only play stronger, but look stronger. Same with getting these capes, the effects of which I'm not sure of. My only complaint playing this game is actually with myself. I couldn't remember which passages I've gone to. But when you finally did find your way through, it reminded me so much of a modern Dark Souls dungeon. And the combat basically revolves around punishing the player for being too greedy. So the player, you, gains strategy as you play, just as your character, Alucard, gets stronger as you play. So long as you save scum, you'll never feel a dip in gameplay. The only time you'll feel like a loser is when you get lost, and you can give in to your weakness and look up where to go online, or you can be like me, who is still not quite sure what transforming into a wolf does.